what is going on? We've got Mr. Clean. That's what we're going to call this truck because it's very clean. So we're just going to go with Mr. Clean. It's a simple name. It's a good name. And I think you guys are going to really agree with the name as the build progresses. Now we've got a couple things we're gonna be doing to Mr. Clean today, and so I'm gonna get on over here to the truck, open up some boxes, and show you what we got.
The video upload schedule is completely inconsistent now, and it's just kind of like whenever I get a video out, but I hope you guys enjoy and appreciate the difference in the content and the fact that if I don't have something to actually install or do or entertain you with on the vehicle, on any of the vehicles, I'm just not gonna post a video.
And I'm also trying to find a camera person who can shadow me, film everything that I wanna film throughout the day between the truck stuff, the outdoor stuff with TikToks and Instagram Reels and YouTube Shorts, and I'm gonna try my best to be able to produce more content, even if it's that mini content all throughout my platforms, but I need to have a camera person to try to step up our quality, and I'm hoping that it'll make the videos much better on YouTube as well.
And I do actually have some tires coming for this truck.
So we've got some sponsored parts in here as well. Huge shout out to Boost Auto Parts. I'm actually not gonna be installing these today, but guys, huge shout out to Boost Auto Parts. I'm gonna leave a website link down in the description below, and if you see me tagging them on Instagram, that is because they are producing a product for this truck. So go give them a follow, check them out. They produce all kinds of tow mirrors and key fobs and wireless phone charging things for your trucks, a whole bunch of different stuff. So definitely go check them out, give them a follow on Instagram, check out their website, and I'm sure you'll be happy with the stuff that you find.
First thing I wanna get out here are some headlights. There are some other parts in this truck that are not for this truck, but most of it is.
Got some headlights, some LED bulbs for those headlights. And then we've also got some cab lights for the truck today.
Some of these places use tape so cheap that you just kinda look at the box funny and it comes off, and sometimes they use tape so freaking sharp. You gotta grab one of your Magnus broadheads that I've already killed a deer with, and I just use it as a backup head because I haven't gotten around to resharpening it yet, to open your box. And here's the thing, guys. I don't know about you, but like, I like the idea of custom built headlights, and we might go that route at some point. It just kills me to think about spending like $1,000 or $1,500 on a set of headlights. I've already tried to buy the $200 or $300, $400 projector second gen headlights, and they just suck. Like anything that's just made like in terms of a high production headlight, it's not really a custom built, and it's not like the lowest end, but it's kind of in the middle. They just suck. Like the middle grade projectors, they're just terrible. The thing that I've always had the most luck with is just getting one or two piece black or smoked or chrome or whatever style of headlights you want, and then buying the bulbs that you want in them, and then you get that OEM fitment, slightly aggressive or aftermarket look, but you still get that high quality lighting upgrade. You might get a little more style with like a projector that comes from a box that's not custom built, but you don't usually get the brightness quality of just buying your own bulbs and putting them in a lower grade set of headlights. Here's the set that we went with. I've got the tape on them right now, but it's kind of like a smoky chrome look. And the reason I went with that is because the wheels in the truck, they're not black. So I didn't want them to be completely black, but I didn't want them to be completely chrome either. I wanted to kind of have like that smoky chrome look, and I think they look sweet. And then I bought my own LEDs for the inside of the headlights that they're completely bright and awesome with the quality of stuff that comes in factory vehicles now. LEDs are the new standard. And then for cab lights, I actually went with a smoked out amber style. I've actually ran this brand of cab light before. They're a little bit different design than the OEM ones. And then they actually come with their own like LED amber set of lights on the inside. So you just hook the wiring up to your factory cab light wiring, and then it's got like these higher grade amber LED lights inside there, and they're actually pretty stinking bright, and they look really good too. This is also gonna tie in with another aspect of the truck that you're not gonna see today. All the amber will make much more sense when we're done, trust me. So one last look here before we put all the smoky chrome lights on the truck. Thank you.
got the headlights on the truck. They look fabulous with the Firehawk LEDs. Not sponsored, but I really like the product, so I bought them a few times now. And now we're working on the cab lights. And yes, I have my drill sitting on top of the cab. I'm sorry, I gently set it there. I didn't chuck it up there. But now we got the new cab lights on, and I'm actually gonna jump on those tires so you can see the difference. And I'm gonna turn them on so you can see the difference as well between the brightness, the quality, the fitment. Side by side, hopefully you guys can see the drastic change. LED amber, stock amber, bigger housing in general. It sits flawlessly flush right across the top of the cab. There's no gaps, no nothing. I put a new seal around it as well when I put the new one in. So that's what we're gonna be doing, putting those all the way along the top. It'll give it a much better look, much cleaner look, and the lighting will match the rest of the vehicle. Well, here are the new amber LED cab lights, new LED headlights, everything turned on, new smoky chrome headlight housings. Yeah, looks pretty good to me. The headlights are so freaking bright now. They actually did have some upgraded ones in there. Once I pulled the other ones out, you could see he actually did have some upgraded LEDs in there, but I just wasn't sure. I don't know. I haven't driven this thing much since I've gotten it so far, so I guess I just didn't realize it already had some LEDs in there. Can't hurt to put a brand new set in. Thing looks freaking beautiful. So I'm super stoked about that. And I'll try to leave links down in the description below for the headlights as well as the amber cab lights, amber LED cab lights. They fit very nicely, very, very flush fitment to the cab. And we shouldn't have any issues with those at all. They do have new seals for them so that the foam can kind of compress and that it'll kind of keep like a watertight seal around there just to make sure nothing gets into your headliner and make your headliner all messy. Very high quality stuff from what I could find. And then and the headlights are a very simple configuration as well. They're just a two-piece headlight for a second gen Dodge. It'll fit anything from 94 to 02. And then all I did was buy some Firehawk LED headlight bulbs, which I'll try to put in the description as well. And then I just drop those in there, and then that's how I get those super bright white LEDs in a super simple headlight setup. And then when you're going down the road, you have nice high quality light without having to spend $400 or $500 or $600 on a custom built set of headlights. Very simple. You don't even need to have these types of headlight housings to use those LEDs. You can literally just use your factory stock OEM headlights and then put LEDs in them. Kind of like this truck, this is just a totally stock headlight setup. This is probably actually the original set, and all I did was took out the factory bulbs and put LEDs in them, and they are incredibly bright now. Oh man, part of me really likes the stretched look just because I feel like it adds to the flavor of this truck the way it sits right now, but it's not going to be looking anything like this very soon. So the next changes that we make are going to fit this thing so nicely. And then here's also a view of the truck without the headlights on, so you can just see the amber look that we're going for with this thing. And I think it's gonna look really good, guys, and I'm super stoked for the next stages of this thing. But for now, you can see how the amber all kind of ties together with the corner lights, mirrors, and the cab lights, and they actually do all look the same in terms of color. The only difference is these ones are closer up, so they look more amber than the rest. But when you get up closer, the amber is all the same shade. It all looks the same. There's just a little bit more because there's a bigger bulb right here in the corner, but it's awesome. And these mirrors are actually going off the truck, and we're getting a brand new set going on there. And it's still going to have that look and this theme, but it's going to be an upgraded set. And I'll show you what I mean in the next video here. Reagan, which one are you taking?
Neither.
Neither? There's there's three of them. You know, all the snow's got me thinking. You could be winning the NASTY Road 12 Valve Cummins plus $5,000 cash and a Western commercial grade snow plow. Moving snow, making money, all that good stuff. I would put the plow on right now, except it's gonna get up to 40 degrees by like midnight tonight, and then all the snow's gonna be gone.
which is kind of gonna suck because I like having some snow because the deer season's not over yet and I love deer hunting so much. Snow just makes it that much more enjoyable to go out. I had a couple other things I was gonna show you, but it required me to drive that truck with all this snow, and the salt trucks have already gone down the road a couple times. With the 14 wise, I really just don't feel like caking this thing in salt right now. It just wouldn't be safe anyways. It doesn't get the best traction on a setup like this. And the snow's coming down heavy and keeping the roads covered up. So I'm not gonna take that chance. But anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed the video and you like the new headlights and cab lights that you can't currently see on the truck. Hopefully you guys like that and you guys are ready to see what's next. We got some big things coming for this. Stay tuned for the next episode. We're gonna give you a little bit of insight on what we're gonna do next. I think you guys are gonna like it. Anyways, guys, stay tuned. And if you want to enter to win that Nasty Red, full valve Cummins with the compounds, fully built towing transmission, all that good stuff, 150,000 mile truck, plus the $5,000 in that plow, like I mentioned. Everything ends on January 7th, which is in like 10 days, and then the giveaway for this truck is gone. So if you want to get in on that, you're running out of time. Thanks so much, guys. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.